Notre Dame number one, West Virginia number three, only the eighth time in the last 50 years two unbeaten untied teams have met in a bowl game to decide the national championship. And it's the second time in 3 years that event has happened here in Tempe, Arizona. Here comes Lou Holtz and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, the winningest university in this football century. West Virginia, number 33, has it at the 7-yard line. And the young man from Jersey City, New Jersey, toppled across the 25 by Michael Smalls, number 9, supporting Major Harris as he looks for three in the first option of the day. And Notre Dame reads it well, and Harris has dropped short of the first down at the 35-yard line by Michael Stonebreaker. We'll give you the deep four in a moment. Third down and 7. And Rice's first pass attempt. He breaks away from Parker. 45-50. And Rice is all the way 40, still on his feet, and tripped up at the 32-yard line. Big third down inside the Mountaineer 30. And it's Rice on the option. No yardage there. In fact, coming up with the ball is 49 Harris. 34. It is good. So Billy Hackett, who made 3 field goals during the regular season, gets no.
And he'll hit you.
Huge forearms and biceps, and he has 4.68 speed. Major Harris gets away from Stonebreaker, has a man open, but can't hit Craig Taylor. Taylor had the ball in his mitts, but couldn't tuck it away. 50-yard line. And now Rice to throw and has a man wide open, the tight end Derrick Brown, to the 27-yard line.
The game is going. Look out.
Leading 3-0, the Irish are on the move. Here's Green. Finally pulled down inside the 15. Another Notre Dame first down. Touchdown. Rice keeps. Rice is to the 3-yard line and close to a first down. Bo Orlando, 22, finally brought into the turf.
A man to make that fine stop off the ground.
It's Banks. No, Rice keeps. Is he in? No, it is Mark Shy of the goal line. Banks, actually, had he been given the ball, would have had a touchdown. Now they're going to touch the fullback or Rice on a keeper. Johnson, touchdown. Anthony Johnson, who scored 5 times this year, the junior from South Bend, Indiana, who was married just before Christmas, and that'll be one he'll be able to tell his bride about.
Well, and I said we might not see more of Anthony Johnson today with that ankle. This is the kind of game that if you can hobble out there, you're going to.
4 shots from the 3-yard line and a bobble snap. And the Irish will not get the extra point. Alvoid Moyes, number 3, was first in to tackle the. We open the second quarter. Still no first downs. And Harris hit from behind. That ball up for grabs and incomplete. Frank Stams is right there with Keith Wynn. Third down call for Rice. And the toss and a fumble. And Notre Dame recovers. Braxton Banks able to fall on the ball. And of course one of the ball in the Irish possession, but they get the first down. From the 38. Brooks. A close to the 45 and a good gain on first down. Orlando and Mays, a company made a hit. Boy, what an arm for Rice running against his body. Down the middle, complete to the tight end. And it's Derrick Brown all the way to the 4-yard line.
Nice pass, nice run.
Well, threatening to make it more than 9-0. They've got a touchdown, Rodney Culver. Notre Dame scores again. The snap, and Pete Graham, who bobbled the snap last time, is the holder. They try the extra point off angle, and Hull knocks it through. The Notre Dame Fighting Irish, very impressive. Now that's why the pass was not only short but offline. The toss outside goes to Unger Johnson, and
somebody he watched a lot.
Third and long. Harris scrambling, throwing, and Craig Taylor has a first down at the 31-yard line. So they got the penalty on the 8 minutes left, second quarter. Brown, a big hole, and a solid open field tackle by Stan Smagala on that left corner.
Your offensive line and saying, hey, we're coming up inside.
Harris. Get some help. Will they run it? Yes. And now he throws. Touchdown. And it was a legal pass. He threw it from the 5-yard line. Jamie Lamon, number 15, has the score. He threw it from the 5, the line of...
Quarterback across the line of scrimmage.
So that's on third down. So fourth down, in comes Charlie Bauman to try a field goal, and he knocks it straight through from 29. That's not what the Mountaineers wanted. They were looking for 7. 16-3, Notre Dame leads. 6 minutes, 9 seconds left, third in the second quarter. Tony Rice balling out to the 42-yard line. Ronaldo Turnbull tripped him up.
Quick story about it.
Fast-moving first half, 3:45 remaining. And now Rice down the middle has a wide open. Number 22, Anthony Johnson, fumbles. Or was he down?
He was down. They point to the spot. Anthony Johnson.
Press.
Well, no pressing here.
On third and long, Rice. Ismail for a touchdown. Boy, that ball threaded through several West Virginia hands to the rocket, and he shot into the end zone with a 29-yard score. And the Irish. And the Irish lead 23-3.
Kind of holding it tight to his shoulder. We'll keep an eye on him.
There's a throw to the sidelines and an immediate hit on Grantis Bell by Stanton. The NFL teams can't boast of that kind of defensive speed. Harris with a flip to his tight end Keith Wynn, and Wynn is dragged down at the 50-yard line, goes out of bounds, stops the clock 13 seconds. Three-man rush. And now stands on a delayed blitz. Harris on the run, throwing for Rembert. They finally found Rembert at the 14-yard line. And with 4 seconds left,
they believe in themselves.
31-yard attempt by Bauman is right in the middle. And that's the end of the first half. A half in which Notre Dame showed its firepower. And the Irish flexed its muscles defensively, stopping the nation's number
at the artificial turf.
Third and 8 from the Mountaineers 42. Stands putting on the pressure. Harris throwing into coverage, and the interception by Pat Terrell. Half to go, third quarter. And Rice looking for Green. He's open, and he's got it at the 27-yard line. Bo Orlando caught up with a perfect throw by Rice.
Hits the target, first and 10.
35-yard play. Now Tony Brooks swings to the outside and has about 10 yards to the 16-yard line. Chris Herring finally tripped him up. To the Notre Dame fight song every day. It was destiny. Brooks zigzagging for maybe a yard. Dale Jackson, the backup linebacker, is played.
Makes a fine play there.
Reggie Ho, the academic All-America. He's got a routine, a little magical touch with the fingers, and now his kick is good from 30 yards. Ho kicked four field goals.
And the ability to scramble, get that extra piece of time.
Second and three. And again open is Taylor. Same play to the other side, and Taylor bulls his way to the 50. Understand that in Chicago to make sure he met the requirements to get into Notre Dame. That's where he wanted to go. Harris drills that one over the head of a tight end Wynn, and a flag is down. He may have roughing the passer on Wes Pritchett.
And that's exactly what we're going to have. Two dead ball.
Rembert is with him. Harris just does get away. And then shows his speed and out of bounds at the 16 with a first down. Don Gray.
Pain in that body right now.
Looks to the end zone, has a man open, Grant for a touchdown. Travis Bell. Flag is down.
It may have been a dead ball foul. And
Bauman tries the extra point. And it's 26-13. Major Harris returns, and the Mountaineers applaud. Rice faking, then going down the middle to Brooks. Intercepted by Willie Edwards. Edwards at the 30. Edwards at the 26-yard line, and West Virginia on its feet. Rembert right. Harris looking for Phillips. He's covered well. Now he throws long for Bell. Oh, what a defensive play by Stan Smagala. Reaching in. 6-6 early in the third. Has scored a touchdown in the third quarter. And now another chance, except Harris has to eat it at the 42-yard line. George Williams and Frank Stams.
Strong side on Parker.
Now Rice back to throw. Has a man wide open. Out of bounds goes Ricky Waters inside the 5-yard line. Waters to the right. He's the man who caught the 57-yard pass. The fake, the throw, the touchdown to Frank Jacobs, who caught only one pass all year for Notre Dame. He's got one for a touchdown in the Fiesta Bowl.
Lou Holtz, such a master when it comes to utilizing his players. Rarely throws in that kind of situation.
Try to put some added distance on the West Virginia Mountaineers. Rice keeps, and does he get in? Yes. He lurched forward and able to get the ball. That was the only thing that got in the end zone, but that's what counts. The two-pointer is good. Arizona, in his third year, won the national championship. This is Rico Tyler, the big fullback, rumbling down to the 37-yard line. And Rockne, in his third year, was the mythical national championship team in 1920. Fourth and about 2.5. Jones rifles it to Tyler. And Tyler has a first down at the 21. He's bigger than
the way it should be played.
Reverse to Rembert, who scored several times on that play and gets one here in the Fiesta Bowl. And the Irish, boy, their tempers are still up. Jones to Rembert. There's has that 6'7 leaping power. Rembert, who gets all 8 points on the touchdown. 8-6 on a reverse. Student at Arizona State and the daughter of Tom and Melva Hansen, the commissioner of the Pac-10 Conference, Tom Hansen. Sarah Hansen wins that honor. And the grand marshal was Janet Evans, who won 3 gold medals in Seoul. And there it is, the final seconds tick away, and Notre Dame will duly celebrate a national championship. No doubt, the Irish are number one.